There's not many famous people in Australian climbing, but if there were, it'd be Lee Cossey and his brother Ben. I'll ask about my climbing and I'd say, oh, I did this cool route the other day. He'd be like, yeah, that's great. And then I'd find out later that was his route, but he wouldn't say, and he did it when he was like 15. Come home from work and he's there and he's asking how my day is, and he genuinely cares.
Yeah, so I started climbing about 20 years ago now. It makes me sound really old. I'm a physiotherapist. Yeah, basically I work with people who have musculoskeletal or other, you know, problems with their body. My uncle was a climbing guide, and so he got me into climbing, taught me how to place gear and set up anchors. And my roots were in trade climbing, and like the vibe in Australia back then was that trade climbing's cool and sport climbing's really for softies. But then, you know, I had a gymnastics background before climbing, and so like really into the, you know, athleticism and that sort of thing. And so sport climbing was instant appeal. I had a few trips to Yosemite, Patagonia, and a bit of everything really.
He's my boyfriend, he's my climbing partner, the person that supports me.
And yeah, she's a huge part of my life. Keeps me really psyched on climbing and motivates me a lot. The newest addition to the mountains is Elphinstone. I've been hooked on putting up new routes and that sort of thing. And I guess it's a bit of a necessity to put a whole lot of energy back into my climbing in the mountains. The thing I was on the other day was High Hopes, and I've spent the last year trying to do it amid finishing off uni and all that sort of thing. It's about 40 metres of questing through steep terrain, and that's unique for us up here. It's really friggin' hard because it's so thin and so technical. There's so much friction on the rock that it affords you this sort of ability to use the holds in ways that you wouldn't otherwise. So body position is really, really crucial. And if you fall, you know, a couple of millimetres outside of that right body position, you just can't even pull on. It is that finicky. It makes it an amazing challenge, and it makes it a really, really complete challenge. It's not just a bicep curl. It's not a display of strength. It's a display of everything you can lay down as a climber. Yeah, it'd be cool to do it before I'm 40.
Take this pocket, you kind of have to mash back three in, and the pinky kind of jams, get this little smeary thumb, and from that you do the two hardest moves probably, which is taking this awesome hold, putting the heel on this smeary pinch, and then going up to the crimp up there, and that's, you stick that, hopefully it's done.
I feel like there's Lee the climber, which has totally molded, you know, the way that I approach my life, and that's given me a lot of skills elsewhere in my life. That's been really valuable to be able to apply that to, you know, my academic side of life, which typically, you know, I've never had confidence in that whatsoever. But as it turns out, you know, climbing's given me confidence in that way.